All right, we're talking this morning with Chip Flory, the editor and publisher of Pro Farmer in Cedar Falls, Iowa. And Chip, you're watching some things that, as a commodity analyst, you haven't watched before.
Yeah. What's going on in Greece is more than a little scary, and the domino effect that we could see unroll from this is very, very concerning. You got to go back to about 2000, I think it was, when we saw kind of a similar situation in Argentina, where their economy was in a meltdown and so on. But the ripple effect coming out of Argentina was nothing close to what we could see coming out of the Greece situation, because I think it's kind of a given that Portugal and Spain aren't far behind. Italy's in that mix. Ireland's in that mix of the countries that could come next. It's just a question of
bankruptcy, or what are you talking
well,
about?
Well, you know, just the bailout and the austerity program. You know, a change in the retirement date is one of the things that's in the plan in Greece, and you know, the Greek people are not going to be happy with a change in their retirement date, and the municipal workers facing a 20% wage cut. We're just looking at an overnight shift in the standard of living of the Greek people. That is essentially what is spurring the riots and so on that are taking place today. Could an austerity program be in the works for Spain, for Portugal, for Ireland, for Italy? Yeah. Yeah, because it's a unified belt tightening that is taking place across Europe right now in a way to try to deal with the debt load that these countries face. Germany is obviously a linchpin in all of this. If they continue to quote unquote play along, and they're playing hardball, there's no question about that. But if at some point they decide that they're just going to put their foot down and say no, we're done, we're not going to bail out these countries that provide very little, or that are at the lower end of the economic contribution to the Eurozone. If Germany just says no, we're out, then it's your problem, Greg, and it's my problem.
How big
and
of a,
everybody else's problem too?
How close to a reality is that Germany would pull out?
Like I said, so far they're still playing hardball. I just want to see them continue to play and be a part of the conversation. It's under 50. You know, it's well under 50% that for a risk that Germany's just going to pull out, but it's something that we've got to consider. The dominoes are already starting to fall. The Germany is going to be a major determining factor in just how many of those dominoes are going to tip. So it's something that obviously we need to keep a real close eye on. The euro is just getting pounded. Everybody, you know, all the experts thought that it was going to stop at 130, and it's gone right through 130, trading right in that 128, 129 range right now. There's talk of par on the euro. In other words, it going right to 100. At the same time, the dollar is moving higher. It's kind of a safe haven, quality play. If Europe was in decent, or we weren't seeing the emotional climax that we could be seeing today in Greece, if we were not seeing that, would people be buying, would investors be buying the dollar and dollar-based investments out of Europe? No way. No way, because it's still a bad situation here. The difference is that while it's bad here, it's worse there. So we're seeing the euro under unbelievable pressure. We're seeing the dollar rally. In the long term, that's bad news for U.S. grain shipments. But we are also seeing this flight to quality among investors. And in the global currencies, the dollar is the quality play right now. Gold is also considered a store of wealth, and so we're seeing the gold market go from some significant declines earlier today to some significant gains as investors are rolling out of those euro-based investments and looking for someplace else to store their money. And right now, it's the U.S. dollar and the gold market.
Is that the same situation that we're seeing in grains? Because really, all the fundamentals would say that grains should be just tanking right now, Chip.
Yeah, we should be under some pressure. This record planting pace, record emergence pace, really good conditions in a lot of areas. Sorry, you know, to the guys down in the southeast, but we've got some great conditions across the heart of the Corn Belt right now, and everything's pointing to a big supply. We've got a big supply coming out of South America. We've got a rallying dollar that is a negative for our exports. So the fundamental side of the grain markets is all lining up to point prices down. But one thing that we've noticed is that when we get into these quality buy days, when gold is rallying with the dollar, late in the day, we're seeing some of that quality buying come into the grain markets, wheat market in particular. We get some spillover into the corn market, into the soybean market as well, where you get a late session surge in grain prices. That's what has been happening. There is no guarantee that that is going to continue to happen, but it's just something that we've noticed has been going on.
So short-term outlook here in the next week or 2 weeks, any ideas?
Oh, man, I wish I was smart enough to figure it out what everything is going on in this global market that we play in now. Just based on the fundamentals, we should see price pressure. You know, that's as simple as it gets. But with all the influence of the outside markets and this quality buy that's going on in some commodities, and gold and grains are participating in that to some degree, you can't rule out another move to the upside. You look at this meal the soybean meal market in particular. We're into a setback right now, but that chart chart looks explosive. We get a day or two of some impressive gains in that meal market, and it can really go. And if it goes, it's going to pull soybeans along.
Well, Chip, I'll let you go. You sound like you've got a lot of things to track there. But just real quick, somebody's interested in Pro Farmer and your services. Just tell us quickly about your services and how people can find out.
Yeah, it's a weekly 8-page newsletter we publish 52 times a year. That's the Pro Farmer newsletter. We've also got a daily service, and whether you get the daily service or the weekly newsletter, it gets you access to what we do on ProFarmer.com as well. Just give us a call, 800-772-0023, and talk to Shelley, and she'll help you figure out which service is the right package for you guys.
And for full disclosure, just so everybody knows, that Pro Farmer is part of the Farm Journal Media family, as is AgWeb, and people can read some of your comments on the Chip's Chore Time blog on AgWeb as well.
That's right.
All right, thanks, Chip.
You bet, Greg.